What jobs are being laid off in 2022? That's a question somebody asked me in the community tab, and so I have done my analysis of the data that's publicly available, and I'm ready to share my findings with you. If we haven't met yet, hi, my name is Masha. I'm a career strategist helping you advocate for yourself and grow your career. If you're interested in growing your career strategically, make sure you're subscribed to this YouTube channel. And of course, give this video a like if this is something that you enjoy because everything helps with the algorithm and I really appreciate it. Finally, leave a comment below if you have any questions or comments. Layoffs 2022. Before we get into the data, I want to make sure that you understand that the data is not going to be 100% accurate and shouldn't be taken as a prescription. I've been using the data that's publicly available on levels.fyi, the self-reported databases of employees that have been laid off, which might not be 100% accurate and might not encompass all of the employees that have been laid off. And finally, not every company had a list attached to them. Also, different companies use different role title conventions. So I did my best when it comes to keyword categorization, and my system got better as I went on. However, there might be slight discrepancies. It might not be 100% accurate. However, we can still see any trends and any insights from it, any patterns that arise. I have analyzed over 3,000 laid off employees from 15 of the largest companies that I could find these public lists of employees for. And all of the data is for employees from the US just so that it was easier to analyze it. And so without further ado, my findings concluded that overall, the highest number of employees that were laid off worked in business operations with 20.03%. Then second place is engineering, and this includes a range of different job titles within the engineering sphere. I divided the categories into engineering, IT, and data just because that's what I was finding among all of the different job titles that I was seeing in these databases. So engineering is number two with 16.59%. Then on the third place of the highest, the most employees laid off from these 15 companies out of these over 3,000 employees was customer success, anybody who was in the customer success space, and that is 16.39%, so very close to engineering. And finally, number four was people and recruiting. I will leave the rest of the breakdown in the comments below if you want to see that. It will be in a pinned comment. So people and recruiting was on the fourth place and it was 9.5%. However, this is total number of employees laid off. And if you look at the frequency of a department being on top of the laid off list, so it was one of the highest percentages of employees laid off per company. I would call it frequency. So that's the frequency of that percentage being pretty high. You will see that it's roughly the same breakdown of these top four, but customer success and people operations recruiting switch spots. So it becomes business operations number one, engineering number two, customer success, people recruiting number three, and then customer success number four. I feel like this frequency is a much more insightful measure here because when we're just looking at the total number of employees laid off, we're not getting the context of how many employees there were to begin with. And while with the frequency, we don't get that context either, we can at least see a trend that out of all of those companies, this department was, there's a pattern, right? This department comes on top. So for example, even though more staff were laid off in the customer success space, more companies more frequently laid off people ops and recruiting staff. So that's what I mean by frequency. However, the truth behind this data is that while we can see how many people were laid off in certain departments, we can't see how big those departments were to begin with. So we can't see the proportion of those departments that were let go of. For example, if a company's legal department consisted of five people and one of them was laid off, that's a 20% cut in staffing, right? That's a 20% drop in how many employees there are in this department. But if we look at this data from, that's, you know, the standpoint that we're coming from without any context on how many employees there are to begin with, it looks very insignificant. So what does this data mean for you and your career? Should you be thinking about changing careers, or should you be studying something else? Quick answer is no. You should not be changing careers or career paths unless your current career path doesn't make you happy and you want to do that. You want to change it, you know, regardless of this data, regardless of who is being laid off. This data shows you where these companies found an opportunity to cut costs, because a lot of them are currently trying to survive the recession, given that a lot of them have overhired and overprojected growth, betting on a healthy economy, but we are entering recession. So most likely, the people who are being laid off are people in departments that either are not bringing revenue right now, or are not going to bring revenue quickly enough for the company to survive. So the company can't invest its resources in this department because it needs to survive, and it also needs to look good for its investors, etc., etc., etc. So it does not mean anything for your career path. And it doesn't mean anything regarding what career trends there are, what are the hottest careers. And it also doesn't mean that, for example, you should not go into people operations or recruiting. It just means that different companies will hire you. You know, recruiting companies are more likely to hire you than companies in-house, if that makes sense. These companies are thinking of themselves. They're thinking about survival, and they're thinking about looking good in front of their investors. And you should think about yourself first as well. You should focus on growing your career and growing your skill set, developing into the person that you want to become. Continue building your skills and experience that will help you stand out as a potential candidate. If you're still worried about layoffs, I completely understand, and I have more content for you that could be helpful. First of all, I have made a video on the warning signs of layoffs, what to look out for. I will leave a link to it down here and up there. And also, I have a video on how to prepare yourself for layoffs. Again, the links will be down there and up over here. So go ahead and watch those videos right now if you're interested. Let me know if you have any questions regarding my research or anything in particular using the comments box below. Like this video if you've enjoyed it, and share with a friend who might be worried about layoffs and thinking about potentially changing careers, because they don't need to, as we have found out. Subscribe to this YouTube channel if you haven't already, because a lot of career strategy content is coming your way and you don't want to miss it. And we can also be friends on other social media. You can find me as Stereotype Breakers. Have a wonderful time of the day you're currently experiencing. Bye.